At daybreak, our male is already at the lek. He's been here every day for the past 3 weeks. Weaker males have dropped out, leaving only those with staying power. He takes his place on a small rise, a spot he's fought hard to secure. A female steps onto the lek and begins her inspection. The males inflate, tails spread, but beyond displaying, they're powerless. It's the female who holds the cards. To a spectator, males might all look alike, but the females can clearly distinguish. Just what they're searching for is not altogether clear. Is choice based on looks or sound, stamina and strength? Despite decades of study, the jury's still out. We do know that successful males display precisely and repeatedly, taking their cues from the females. They know not to be too aggressive and mount only when invited. Surprisingly, most males never get a chance to mate. Nearly all the females select only one or two males on the lek each year. In fact, 3/4 of females often choose the very same male. Clearly, they see something they want to pass on to their offspring. A female stands beside our male, sizing him up. She approves and gives her solicitation display. The best males can mate, fight off competition, then mate again, all in under a minute. Scientists recently counted a single male mating 37 times with 37 females in 37 minutes. Once they've bred, the hens have no further need for the male. They'll raise their offspring alone.
Extended families of females and youngsters are headed up by a dominant male, the silverback. He defends his territory by intimidating any rivals from among his neighbors.